Okay, I'm just going to talk about Argentina. Apparently, there's some kind of possibility that they'll dollarization. And that literally is taking the US dollar. Well, it could be any currency. And I'm going to discuss that. But yeah, it's taking the US dollar and saying no more Argentinian peso. We're going to be the US dollar now. So they just literally convert straight off the bat, and they have US dollars as their currency. Now, they can take any country's currency, if the country says, hey, yeah, and go with it. They can go with euros, they can take Mexican pesos, they can take rupees, they can take whatever they're into. And in a way, we should be honored and say, hey, the fact they thought of the US, they thought of the US dollar, marvelous. Because in a way, it gives us a boost, kind of like, I'm not going to say another, like a Puerto Rico or something, but they're not going to become a statehood. They're not joining into this ridiculous union of US states that I can't stand. Because I really think they should be abolished, but they're not joining in that way. It will literally just be the money scene. And that's just stopped them from IMF and all of that. So now you can say, well, maybe they'll just be corrupt with it. They'll just take the US dollar and be corrupt all over the place. Well, that happens here with the US dollar. And a corruption of the US dollar itself, they're not going to be printing it, they're not going to be counterfeiting it. And that's really the corruption of the US dollar. The corruption is what, if you corrupt the dollar itself, corrupt its form. There's the version of corruption. Well, that happens just all the time anyhow. So if you're dealing with, well, it's just a currency. So if you have one bad guy and he goes around and cheats people or hurts people, then that corruption, and he uses the dollar in doing that. That's just a currency that got caught in that corruption. So I don't really think we should say, hey, it's a US dollar. We don't want it fashioned with any form of political instability and blah, blah, blah. You need to separate the fact that the currency itself, the dollar itself, is a, as long as it's not being counterfeited, then what's the big deal about it? It's still going to be the dollar for the dollar. Now if you're saying so anyway, so it actually should be a jubilation. If we do this, we should be quite excited. We should be like, hey, because now you could just fly to Argentina. You wouldn't have to do any change of anything. It would be you using your credit card, be the same. There would be no change. There, it's just going to be the cash is the cash is the cash all the way across. It doesn't mean it's necessarily going to be, easy, because it's still going to be a language difference. If anything, you're going to have a lot of people from other countries in South and Central America. Moving into Argentina just to use US dollars. So you're going to have a kind of an attraction there and go say, hey, I just want to earn and live with US dollars. And just like you have the attraction here to this USA, it's a stable currency. I mean, you can look at Mexico and go, well, there it is, and there, and it's just keep going. It just is just expounding, just like an infinite continual doom dollar, doom peso. Dollarization is a great idea for them also. So, you know, and we can get mad and say, all these people are coming here to the USA. Well, they have a very unstable currency. You know, can you imagine going to work and, you know, you worked and let's say you made $300 that week or whatever, you know, equivalent to work wages here. And anyway, so if you say you made $300 and then the next week that $300 is only worth $150, because the currency just decided to again reduce and just inflate and do whatever it does. So all of your work and your effort, which was $300 worth, you only now, you have the 300 still, but it's really only worth 150. So it's really taking a toll on the people. So when you have a stable currency, there's less reason to want to leave your country. You'll be like, well, this is a good one, you know. It's staying here. It's saying, this is $5, and I can buy this with it, and it's not fluctuating into anything drastic, and it's still staying there. Our wages are still staying at the same. Our earning, you know, what we're taking home, we have stability with that. So you have to look at that fact. So that actually, in the long run, will help the immigration issue. It'll slow it down. It'll cool it down. Now, this is just Argentina, but all of these Central American countries definitely should have on the board a dollarization. As a technique to straighten up their economies. Okay, so how come it's great for us, let's say Americans or whatever? Well, it's great for businesses. Obviously, it's always going to be great for businesses. Interchange of commerce, it just makes it all simpler. You have flight issues. Everything is simpler on the flights. Even it's going to be almost like it's going to be like another state, but it's going to be with the country Argentina. So it's going to be a little interesting if you were a property buyer. You go there and buy property. It's in your same currency. It's stable. You buy a house for $100,000 there. It's $100,000, and it's not a peso style that is going to be, well, that's really only worth $50,000, and so you have all of this ridiculousness going on. So I can't even do it gets so crazy, the drops and all. I don't know. So my take on it is it's actually a very good deal, and it is a freedom boost for Argentina. It'll be an attraction state. It'll bring attraction to them. Whereas before, everybody's like, no, stay away from Argentina. It's dangerous. It's dangerous. Their currency is unstable. Run. Instead, it'll be the opposite. It'll be like, hello, you know. So not a problem. Not a problem. That's my take on it. And I'm sure people will think otherwise, that it's a very bad idea. But when you're having, you know, even Europe, you know, Europe, they'll be, yeah. That's not a problem. I'll trade more with you now. You will do euro to dollar. That's any of your commerce that you have there. Anything you create in your little Argentina, we'll be buying it. That's a stable currency. It's easier for suppliers and buyers. I mean, it's just easier across the board. I mean, can you imagine? You're just like, okay, yeah, I'll buy all those puppets. You know, I'm gonna buy 10,000 puppets, and with those 10,000 puppets, well, you know, you buy them at a specific price, and let's say you want another 10,000. Well, the prices are going to be so different and fluctuating all the time. There's no reliability. Okay, so you're as a business, you're like, well, maybe the puppet thing is a bad idea with that country. I'm getting all confused, and I just want the price set, you know. I just want to buy my puppets at a certain price all the time, $1,000 for that many puppets. And I want to buy that every 6 months or something. And that's just, that's easier. That's just easier business. But when wages are changing, when the all of that is going around like this, it's impossible. It's impossible. They can't have commerce with other countries. It just makes it next to impossible. So it'll really, really be a firm standing for Argentina, for a change. So I really am an advocate for it. I think a lot of these Central American countries need to really start thinking about it. Anyway, that's it for tonight. I'm sure I'm missing something with it. There were other bonuses with the dollar being down there, aside from, you know, you don't want to get all this, but this is the way we do things in America, and you have to do that there in Argentina. You don't want to do any of that. It's just the dollar. That's it. They just use dollars now. You don't ever have to step foot in there with your American motives. Just that's it. They just trade the currency dollar, and that's it. And that keeps it right away. It's just cheaper on the United States, because once you start opening up, it's like, well, we have to go in there and finagle them and move them around and rearrange this, and you're becoming the United States Argentina, instead of just staying out of it and just be a currency like a Dogecoin, and you'll be fine. It's less costly. So chances are that won't happen, and they'll say, no, we want to be our hands in the pie. And if they want their hands in the pie, then it's going to become a costly endeavor for the United States to be involved with it. So anyway, that's it.